the semiconductor technology is at my heart, but also at the heart of the economic competition between the US and China, which has led to several restrictions on China's ability to access this critical technology. And there are two major parts to this. First, restrictions on the most critical semiconductor manufacturing equipment produced by companies like ASML, Lam Research, Keeley, and others. And the second part is directly affecting the sales of advanced AI chips to China. These restrictions are clearly stimulating domestic developments in China. As a chip designer, I'm purely interested in specs and facts. So today, let's dive into the most advanced AI chips from China that are, according to some specs, even better than NVIDIA GPUs. Let me explain. Before the US restrictions took effect, the NVIDIA's share of Chinese AI market was over 90%. But now, as we will see, many other companies are trying to get a slice of this pie, including companies like Huawei, Alibaba, and MetaX, and many startups like Beeren, Enflame, Huygen, and many others. They are doing okay so far, but there are three main challenges that all of these companies are facing related to the design, manufacturing, and the software stack for these new chips. Let's start with the first one, designing chips. Without a doubt, they can get the brightest minds to design chips. However, no one is drawing circuits by hand anymore, like it was many decades ago. It's just not possible to place and route 200 million transistors in a square millimeter by hand. For the last decades, we've been using electronic design automation tools, or so-called EDA tools, for this. These tools run a lot of math in the background to find the perfect spot for each transistor, or better to say, for each logic cell in a chip, in order to achieve the best metrics in terms of power consumption, speed, and area. And these tools are an absolute work of art. So smart, so quick, and so capable. So far, all the Chinese companies and startups are using Synopsys and Cadence EDA tools, and Synopsys and Cadence are American companies. They are already under some partial restrictions related to the gate all-around technology, which are mostly sub-3-nanometer designs. Yet, it doesn't stop Chinese companies from using these tools for designing, let's say, 7- and 5-nanometer chips. However, Huawei started to develop their own in-house EDA software, and right now they're running a pilot version of it. And reportedly, this pilot version can handle chip layouts down to 14 nanometers. I guess it's just a matter of time until Huawei can fully switch to their in-house designed EDA software. We will talk about some very promising startups later on, but currently the most competitive AI GPU in China is Huawei 910B GPU. It's an analog of NVIDIA's A100 GPU and fabricated by SMIC, or some call this company SMIC, in 7 nanometers domestically. From the officially available specs, this GPU is capable of 512 teraflops at 8-bit precision. Yet, if we compare it to NVIDIA H20 GPU, which is the best chip NVIDIA can sell on Chinese market right now, it's capable of 296 teraflops at 8-bit precision, again according to its official specifications. So, in theory, 910B is more powerful than NVIDIA H20 GPU, and it's closer to the performance of A100 GPU. However, all these official specs are provided at 1 GHz clock, and as we know, the clock speeds can be changed easily. So here, I personally still bet on the performance of NVIDIA GPUs. Let me know what you think in the comments. The 910B GPU is definitely in high demand in China. Many Chinese hyperscalers have placed orders for it, which Huawei is trying to fulfill. Baidu recently bought hundreds of servers containing new Huawei GPU. They've already received them and ramping them up for LLM training. And what's more, Alibaba and Tencent are lining up too. And fulfilling this demand is a big challenge for SMIC. Both Huawei GPU and Kirin mobile chip fabricated at the same SMIC fab, which has limited capacity of about 25 to 30,000 wafers a month, which can be very roughly translated into about 10 million GPUs a year. And it's pretty clear that right now it's a very unique moment for Huawei to step into AI hardware game. And they are reportedly prioritizing the fabrication of AI GPUs over fabrication of their mobile chips, which go into the Mate 60 phones. It's worth mentioning that Huawei chip is in 7 nanometers, and TSMC fabricating a 7 nanometer chip with very high yield, using EUV machines from ASML that SMIC has no access to. Instead, they're equipped with some older immersion deep ultraviolet machines, DUV machines from ASML. Still, they're able to fabricate 7 nanometer and 5 nanometer chips with these tools using multi-patterning techniques. I won't go too much into the details about this process in this video because I've previously made one about half a year ago, explaining exactly how they manage it. And you can check it out right after this video. The fact is, it's working, just at a bit lower yield, which makes this fabrication or cost per die more expensive. So to keep up with the demand, SMIC is now opening new fabs. And I believe that with time and substantial investments, which they are getting, they will be able to solve the manufacturing bottleneck. And even if they won't be able to go beyond 5 nanometers due to the limitations of DUV machines, they are in parallel to this investigating other lithography techniques. One of them concerning the use of particle accelerators instead of EUV machines. You say impossible? I don't think so. By the way of comparison, the EUV technology is also very complex, and it was considered impossible by many. And it took ASML at least a decade to make it work. Let me know what you think in the comments. Unfortunately, I happen to know that about 60% of you watching this video are not subscribers. If you've ever enjoyed my videos, could you consider subscribing to the channel? The bigger the channel gets, the bigger the guests that I can interview for you get. Thank you! For China to be self-sufficient in the manufacturing of AI chips, they need to figure out the fabrication of high bandwidth memory. As we discussed in my previous videos, memory bandwidth is one of the biggest bottlenecks of GPU performance. China has no high bandwidth memory production at the moment, but as it was rumored already last year, SXMT, SX Memory Technology, was buying some older memory manufacturing equipment from Applied Materials and Lam Research, and right now it's already ramping up its production. It's generally agreed that Huawei has already some quite decent AI GPUs. But it's not only about designing a GPU and then manufacturing it. You also have to build a software stack for it to make use of its architecture, or to take advantage of its architecture and efficiently distribute the workloads. And that's actually one of the keys that made NVIDIA a leader in AI hardware. One of the key factors that enabled NVIDIA to shift from a gaming to AI giant was the development of their software stack, CUDA. At the same time, they've also heavily invested in the developing hardware for deep learning, like their Tensor Cores. And by optimizing the whole stack, NVIDIA has developed more efficient processing of deep learning algorithms. And now, with the boom in generative AI, NVIDIA is benefiting from their long-term strategy. And this is another challenge for Chinese companies and startups, because building a software stack from scratch for a new piece of hardware is a big deal. Some Chinese companies, like MetaX, trying to make their hardware to work with NVIDIA CUDA platform, just making it compatible. Others are investing in developing of their own software stack, like Huawei. And Chinese startup BRN has struggled with this too. You might be surprised why I haven't started this video with BRN, because BRN was considered one of the most competitive GPUs in China. They've successfully raised several massive rounds of funding from top investors. And in August 2022, they presented their new BR100 GPU. And I remember them at Hot Chip Conference, where they were presenting it right after Tesla introduced their Dojo supercomputer. Beeren's BR100 GPU was built on TSMC's 7 nanometers, and they are using TSMC's advanced packaging technology called chip-on-wafer-on-substrate packaging. And they used this packaging because it allows to integrate multiple dies and memory in one package. And that's at the core of this chip, which is, if you look into it, resembles a lot NVIDIA GPU's architecture. But the problem with this packaging that at the moment there is no manufacturer in China who can do COWS packaging. Anyway, Beeren was doing great overall. Its single chip performance was reaching petaflops levels, which is comparable to the latest NVIDIA GPUs, until TSMC suspended the manufacturing of Beeren GPUs due to the export regulations. And so now they might have to change or pivot a little bit in the design to be able to fit to domestic manufacturing offerings. Still, they continue to raise money and have just raised another round of $280 million. I will be keeping an eye on them. Moore Threads is another Chinese company that has been developing gaming and data centers GPUs for a couple of years now. Their latest GPU, S4000, is designed for AI acceleration in data centers. It is capable of 200 TOPS at 8-bit precision and 100 teraflops at 16-bit precision. So it isn't super fast. However, it's already been used for training of large language models. They've built a cluster out of 1,000 GPUs and used it to train a 70 billion parameter model in 1 month. We don't know much more about this GPU. Apart from that, they also used to be clients of TSMC. Now they won't have any choice. Obviously, they will have to switch to SMIC technology, which is already overbooked. As you see, NVIDIA has no shortage of competition in China. There are many startups who are pitching their hardware to the companies even before they have a prototype ready. Like the state-backed Hagen Technology, which is marketing its new GPU, Shenzhen 2. And there is one big advantage that this chip is reportedly compatible to NVIDIA's CUDA platform, which means that NVIDIA customers can easily switch them with minimal design changes. Then, just last month, the startup called IntelliFusion announced its DeepH10 chip. And the company claims that this chip is compatible to NVIDIA's H20 GPU. But again, I found no specs. It definitely looks like there is no lack of chip designs and chip designers in China. But the problem is that the most of the advanced packaging and manufacturing capabilities in China are likely to be prioritized for Huawei. So these startups will have to think twice about where they will manufacture their new chips. Having in mind everything we discussed today, the whole picture, I'm pretty sure that in 5 years, they will have managed to figure out the manufacturing process. You know, they're already training AI models similar to GPT-4, GPT-4.5, and pretty soon they might be able to do it on their own domestically designed and manufactured hardware. And this will be a huge win for China. And if you want to support me creating more videos for you, you can do so through Patreon. You can find all the links in the description to this video. Thank you so much, and I will see you very soon. Ciao.